We're bad friends.
I mean, did you see, I wanted to be so supportive, but Coming to America too?
I did not watch it. I did see it on my Netflix or whatever. What is on HBO?
I don't know.
Amazon.
But there was a
scene. Is it Amazon?
Yeah.
Oh. And you want to root for it, right?
No, I don't. Because our friends are in it?
No, you just kind of want to root for, because it's comedy.
No, I don't. I disagree. I don't like sequels in that regard. I think it's like, leave those things alone. I've always been that way. I'm like, why? We don't.
All right, but that's why I saw it.
No, I didn't need Dumb and Dumber again. I don't need.
Caddyshack
2.
I'm just telling you why I saw it.
I don't want Animal House again. Leave these things alone.
I know.
Leave them alone.
I know.
All right, so you support it. But yeah, we have friends that are in it, so which is nice.
Yeah, I have so many people that I know. So many people.
Very nice.
But I couldn't get through. There's in the opening, right?
Is it bad?
Oh my God.
It's that bad.
It's like, so what's the fucking McDowell's?
Yeah, McDowell's. It was called McDowell's, right? Yeah.
So I don't know what's the country that Eddie Murphy's character comes from. Is it a African country that's like
Zamunda? Yeah,
Zamunda, right? Yeah. So now there's a McDowell's
in Zamunda. Very funny. I like that.
Right. So there's a scene where Eddie Murphy, Arsenio Hall's character, they're all at McDowell's
in Zamunda.
Yeah, and it's shot in a weird way where it's like, basically, it's a wide shot, essentially, right? And you have, the main cast, but then you have people around them, staying around them, and everyone says something. But Louis Anderson's there.
Love.
Who, like, because he was in the first movie.
He worked at McDowell's.
Yeah, in Chicago or wherever it might have been, right?
He was the mop boy at McDowell's.
Right. Yeah. So now he lives in Zamunda. Everyone's there because he's a, Louis's doing great.
Yeah.
It is.
Say it.
If I wanted to take my iPad, I was watching on my iPad, right?
Yeah.
Lay it down on my hard wooden floor.
Or put it in a microwave.
Put my anus against, the screen and just
shit your way through it.
Yeah. It was that bad.
Really? Not one joke made you laugh?
It just the whole thing made me cringe.
But be honest. Was it because of the reminiscence of how much you liked the original, or was it because it was just?
It just didn't seem right. It's almost as if we were living in a different dimension, right? Like I was like some evil dimension,
right?
Right, and like I was like tied to like a chair made out of meat carcasses. You know what I mean? And there were like eyeballs flying by with wings, right? Right, and like I see my hands and there's teeth. Right, and I'm being right, and there's like a fat lady that's slimy, right, with like two forks sticking out of her eyes, right, like right,
yeah,
and then and the lady with the forks, right, she comes and gives me the iPad and shows me the scene, and I'm in this meat carcass scene. That's what it felt like. Like it was a nightmare.
By the way, that's the best movie review I've ever heard in my life.
Right. And it was just, at that point, right, I was sweating.
Yo, you were getting
my
nervous.
My shirt off, was off, and I was like, like I was having a panic.
Yeah.
And because I love the first movie.
I mean, literally one of my favorite movies of all time. Yes.
Classic, right? Yes. And then you could see they're doing other people's, they have the other characters.
Well, they were using old jokes too?
No, yeah. Arsenio is playing the other characters. They play three or four different characters,
at the
right?
barbershop.
But it's like, Arsenio's so old. He still looks like the old guy. You know what I mean? Like that. There's a preacher guy who's old too.
Yeah, yeah.
They look the same age now. Like it's almost as if they didn't even have to do makeup or whatever.
They're like, you're good.
You have to watch it. It's something special.
Well, I wanted to watch it, but I didn't because I like supporting our people that we know that are in things. But
yeah.
But my issue with those things, I'm telling you, I hate what's that called, Andres?
Sequel?
What is it?
Sequel.
It's a reboot. Yeah, like Ghostbusters, it was a reboot. It wasn't a sequel. It wasn't a remake. The all female cast was a reboot.
Okay, so I'm trying to think of. I haven't heard of one reboot in my mind that I said, oh, I'm glad they did that.
All right, I'm thinking about it right now. Let me think.
Because there was one called that was one of the worst movies ever made. It was called Flatliners.
Oh, I remember Flatliners.
Yeah.
Yes, I remember that movie.
So the first movie was okay growing up.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
They redid it.
I know.
Oh my God. Wait. And I always watch them.
Right.
Oh, you know what?
Oh, well, there you go. What about Godzilla?
Yeah, the first Godzilla, the 2014 Godzilla with Bryan Cranston.
Yeah, it was great.
Was great.
Yeah, it was so good.
That was good.
Okay, so we got one.
Okay, but I just saw another Kong versus.
No, I wouldn't watch it. I refuse.
Why?
I just don't want that. It's just because I can't see it in a movie theater, honestly.
Yeah.
I need to see that in a movie theater. Why am I watching that at my house on my iPad?
It's just.
The movie theaters are open.
Are they open again?
Yeah, they are.
Not here in LA.
I saw it in the theater.
You went to see a movie?
Yeah.
Why the?
Also, when they advertise it, you know, premiering on at movie theaters and IMAX, HBO Max.
Right.
It's like, I'll watch it here.
I'll watch it here. Yeah, but that movie, what did you go see in the theater, Dres?
I went to see the Kong versus Godzilla.
Okay. What did you think of
it? And how was it?
It was pretty bad.
But here's what takes me out of it in the beginning of it, right? It's just, they show Kong, right?
Yeah.
In the jungle, right, Andreas?
Yeah.
And he's like, he wakes up, he smells the, you know, trees.
Yeah.
And then there's a waterfall and he's taking a shower.
Cute.
Right? Like a cute, it's cute. Almost as if Kong, you know what I mean? He seemed way too human, right? And cute for me, right? And as soon as they did that, and also you can tell it's CGI.
They couldn't get a real Kong?
No. That's not my point, man.
I know what you're saying.
No, my point
but
is.
But let me ask this. Is there a reason they humanized him? For the sake of the story of the film, Andres?
No, it was just like the scene in Shrek. You know, like kind of like that opening in Shrek.
That wasn't like a choice. That was just a thing they did.
Yeah.
It wasn't for the film.
It's like a video game, the whole movie. Is
Here's my point. Okay, my point. I'm not a movie reviewer, but here's my point. Okay, what makes that Godzilla from 2014... good,
yeah,
is you don't see Godzilla until like 25% inside in the movie.
All right, so we'll poo-poo that.
But you know what? When they do American remakes in movies, right? Like the Ring, the American Ring.
Yeah, it was good.
Was scary.
I liked it. Yeah, it was.
Oh, have you seen? You saw the American Ring?
I think.
Good.
Mm. I don't remember
the Ring.
Yeah, I watched the Ring.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah.
You've been on the show now for so long. Even if you didn't, just say yes. And just go with it. The American Ring was good. You liked it, right? Bob?
I saw the ring with you.
No. Yes.
Thank you, Rudy. Very good.
Very good. Very good. That was a test.
That was so good. Rudy Jules.
Oh, yeah.
Swish. God, you're good.
Yeah. But so I bring this up because LeBron is doing
Space Jam. Yeah. No thanks.
But did you see the trailer?
The original is one of my favorites.
But did you see the trailer though?
Yes. It looks cool.
Pretty good.
It looks cool, but
I know.
It's just something about, and also Michael Jordan.
Right.
Michael Jordan. What do you mean? Michael Jordan.
But it's also, you know, at one point these movies like Predator or whatever these movies are, yeah. Right? At one point, these movies were original.
Planet of the Apes, right?
That's, right. So Ghostbusters, when you first saw it, you had never seen anything like it.
Yep.
It's like, you know, it's played real, but the ghosts are, you know, I mean, goofy and cartoony.
Totally.
Four really funny people, you know what I mean, in the movie, right? And it's just like, it's action-packed. It's family-friendly,
yeah,
right?
To a degree.
Adults like it, you know what I mean? Because Bill Murray's like the king at the time, you know, in terms of, he still is, right?
Yeah.
And it worked, right?
Harold Ramis is a genius.
It is a genius. So my point is that, you know, at one point, these movies were original. It came from somebody's mind.
Right.
And it's fresh, right? And then when you redo it, it's like, what happened to creativity? Let's take a fucking risk.
Well, they don't want to take a shot right now because Hollywood's owned by China and we have to have films that sell well overseas. Andres, am I right?
Absolutely.
100%. You have to have these films all have to do well overseas now. It used to be independent studios could exist. They could invest in a small movie like Lorne Michaels' Slate used to get more love, right? Like a sketch on SNL could be a fucking dynamite movie.
Yeah.
Now those things are impossible to make.
Yeah.
Coneheads, one of my favorite movies of all time. Coneheads was so funny.
Yeah.
Talking about an original concept, an alien family that gets to fit in with a normal family. He becomes the most beloved guy in his neighborhood. Dan Aykroyd was so fucking funny in that. That movie couldn't be made now. You'd have to sell that with like, I don't know, fucking Chris Hemsworth and what
Jackie Chan maybe. Yeah, maybe because you're right.
Yeah, it just you can't. It's just not the same. You know what we watched last night? I put up a clip online 2 nights ago. We watched Beverly Hills Ninja, Farley's movie.
Mm.
Bro,
yeah,
I fucking loved love that movie. Yeah, and, yeah. And I watched it again thinking, is this going to be as funny now?
Yeah.
Yep. Didn't miss a fucking beat. It was so fucking funny.
That's why when you watch something like, I mean, think about this, like Dr. Strangelove.
I mean, what a great film.
Right?
Yeah.
A movie like that will never happen again.
Maybe.
I mean, the odds of it, though. You know what I want to do right now? Because I've never really done this. I'm going to tell you, and this is really true. I'm not just saying this out of my own mind, right? Just to, you know, my top 10 movies are movies that everyone has to see because they're movies they'll never make again type of movies.
Okay.
Okay. I'm not going to do 10 of them. I'll just do two or three.
Okay.
Oh, I know, but you just seem so disappointed in it.
Well, because I was like, whoa, cool. You're going to do 10.
I just can't, because I'm just thinking of it right now, okay. Right?
All right, give it.
So Peter Sellers in the movie Being There.
Being There.
Did you see it?
No.
Paris, Texas.
I've seen Paris, Texas.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's
Wim
not.
Wenders. That's one of my favorite movies.
Oh, okay. No, I like it, yeah. Go ahead.
Why is it so hot in here? Have you noticed it's really hot in here?
It's hot outside. They're trying to sweat us out. Okay, Paris, yeah. Texas is great.
Yeah, Paris, Texas is great. And I'll tell you how the movie opens.
Well, don't give anything
how it opens. How it opens.
Oh, yeah.
First of all, it's my favorite love story of all time.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
You know what mine is?
What?
Raising Arizona.
Bro. What are you standing for?
I don't know.
What are you standing for?
You stood up. I stood up. No, I thought we were going to hug or kiss or fight.
No, that scared the fuck out of me. I wanted to fuck you just now.
I know. I was gonna kiss you, but I came too hot.
Yeah, that was really
I came in too hot.
Aggressive.
I got to work on that.
You
got to
slow. Let me do it again, right?
Go ahead.
This is how you should have done it, right?
Well, no, let's
see. Paris, yeah. See, okay. Raising Arizona.
Well, you know what my favorite love story is?
What?
Raising Arizona.
You're doing it wrong.
Too hot? Coming in too hot. Damn, I got to learn how to do this.
Wait, do it. Right.
How is that balancing on
the table?
Can
you do it with your face first?
Yeah, sorry.
Try it with your face, right?
All right, yeah, my bad.
So try it with your face first and then slowly maybe get up.
Okay, here.
Right? But don't be so like aggressive.
Well, you know what my favorite love story is?
What?
Raising Arizona.
Right, okay.
It is such a good movie.
Yeah, yeah. It really is good.
Nathan Arizona, sell you some furniture.
Have you seen that movie?
Yes.
Correct.
Yeah, what is it about?
It's about a family who lives in Arizona.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a comedy skit?
It is
a comedy skit, right? And then what is it that's just the premise about, though?
They go...
Don't pick at your cheese pie plate.
They
Focus. Go...
They go... They go to school.
They go
or
to
they
school.
Go to work, the adults, and... Yeah.
Okay.
Well, that's also true. What's the big thing that happens in the movie? What do they do? What do these two do in the movie? They get a...
They get in prison.
They get in prison. Prison.
That's right.
That's
because
right.
You saw the photo.
That's right. They get in prison.
That's very nice.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm glad you like that.
One of my favorites of all time.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. What's
your
next?
Are you a Coen Brothers fan?
Yeah. What the fuck? What haven't they made that I like? That I don't like? I mean, I don't think I've disliked any of their movies.
Like even Barton Fink?
Sure, it's fine.
It's fine. It's weird.
I like it because it's quirky. It's not something I'm going to watch again.
Hudsucker Proxy.
Fine.
Fine. Yeah, fine. But then they have like Country of...
No Country of Old Men.
Yeah, oh my God.
One of the best movies of all time.
Yeah. Fargo?
Come on.
Oh!
Give me a fucking
one of the best.
Okay, well, there's a caveat.
Yeah.
Fargo, the TV show, I loved as much as I love the fucking movie.
Here's the thing. I've never seen it.
What?
Everyone tells me to watch it.
Holy fuck.
And I go, I love the movie so much.
No, dude, you would love. Have you seen the TV show, Drace?
Yeah.
How good is it?
It's incredible.
It's fucking, look at me, fucking incredible.
Right,
you've seen Fargo, right?
Yes.
Right? Remember, what happens in that pilot episode of Fargo, the TV show?
The father shits himself.
Shits himself. It's unreal, dude. You have to see it, Bobby. It's so good. and on the heels of that, he shits himself. And then what happened? Remember what his mother does then when she finds out?
The mom makes it into a pie.
It makes it into a pie, the shit?
The shit.
Wow.
It's a shit pie. That's like
sounds really good.
The pilot episode is called Eat Shit Pie.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
Bob.
So really.
Holy fuck.
Because everyone tells me to watch it.
It was one of my favorite shows.
I refuse.